所以大家 ，Let's stand up from our feet， 我们从我们的座位上起立。Let's welcome 刘子钧牧师来到我们当中分享今天的信息。Let's welcome Pastor 刘子钧 ，Welcome。
哎，我们再给耶稣一个热烈热烈的拍掌，好不好？大家请坐。感谢主，非常高兴可以来到你们当中。
Good to be here with you guys today.
我们在在过去这几一年左右，我听到很多次你们关于你们教会的事情。
I've heard a lot of great things about you guys this past year.
都是好事。
All good things.
而且看到你们的增长，还有你们正在影响我们的城市跟国家。
And to see you guys impacting our city, impacting our nation.
我心中非常非常的感动。
I'm so excited.
所以我这次彼得牧师请我来呢，我也很开心。
And so it's just great to be here with you guys today.
然后我也我只有一个小小的不开心而已。
There's only one thing that I'm not too happy about.
就是你们在网络上宣传的那张照片。
The picture we put up online of me.
我不知道为什么你们一定要把彼得牧师拍得那么帅，然后邀请的讲员一定要放大他的。
It's a great picture. It's a great picture. It's a great picture.
不是
It's impossible. It's impossible to make him look anything not handsome.
不是这样子，不是这样子的。
All right,
他以为我听不懂，对？来来来，我慢慢等你翻完这一句，我再讲下去。
God is good. Jesus is here.Well, the picture we put up, he's complaining that it's a little bit, he's a little bit fluffy in that picture. But we're trying our best.
后来我今天来到这里，我就知道了一件事情。
And so once I came here, I realized something.
你们邀请的讲员的那个标准呢，就是长得比 Peter 丑了，就可以凸显他有多帅。
We have to invite somebody who is uglier than Pastor Peter, which is, yes. Yeah. No, I'm just kidding.
不过，感谢主
but,
感谢主，我只被邀一次，整常常来讲道。
But Pastor John is always here, so we're not saying anything, right? Pastor John is coming back next month to preach. So,
你们这一堂可以不要直播吗？
已经直播出去了。It is on internet forever for all eternity.
Okay, 那我们再重来一次。我非常喜欢训正牧师。
I love Pastor John.
今天很高兴跟你们一起分享神的话语。我想今天的主题叫亚伯拉罕的秘密。
And today I want to share with you Abraham's secret. I'm so excited to share with you with the word of God today.
经文在创世纪的二十一章。
I'm going to read to you from Genesis chapter 21.
Okay, so Peter, 你帮我念英文就好，我们就过去这个。
Oh, 好。All right, this is okay. So we're just going to read from the English from the King James version. Why are you laughing? It's a King James, man. And the Lord visited Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did unto Sarah as he had spoken. For Sarah conceived and bare Abraham a son in his old age. At the set time in which God had spoken to him, Abraham called the name of his son that was born unto him, whom Sarah bore to him, Isaac.
你知道以撒这个名字呢？原文里面就叫做喜笑跟喜乐。
The name Isaac in the original Hebrew means laughing and joy.
你要知道，上帝的应许成就，往往是带着非常快乐的时刻。
See, God's promises come to pass in moments of joy.
这当我踏进你们教会的时候呢，我心中非常高兴，因为你们这是一个喜乐的教会。
And I'm so happy to see you guys being a joyful church.
你们还派一个人上来讲一个我连台湾人都听不懂的台语，这也是非常喜乐的事情。
And we send somebody up here to speak Taiwanese, and nobody in Taiwan actually understands.
可不可以给你们刚刚那个传道吗，弟兄，鼓励一下
？Yeah, let's give DJ a hand. We'll put up his number later on for you guys to.
你知道教会本来就应该是充满了喜乐。
See, the church of God is supposed to be filled with joy.
圣经里面告诉我们说，我们就要走到神祭坛，到我最喜乐的神那里。
The Bible says, when we come before God, it's to a place of joy.
这个世界充满了许多黑暗，但是来到神的家，应该要更欢喜快乐。
There's a lot of darkness outside in the world, but when we come into the house of God, we're supposed to experience joy.
诗篇告诉我们说，当我们常把耶和华摆在我们面前，我们的心就欢喜，灵就快乐，肉身可以安然居住。
Psalm says, as you set the Lord before you, there's going to be joy in your heart.
我从小到大是在教会长大，因为我的爸妈是牧师。
See, I grew up in the church because my dad, he's a pastor.
我一辈子都在梦想有像你们这样的一个教会。
I've always been dreaming about having a church like this.
但是从来没有成真过，因为我们聚会很像追思礼拜。
So often our services is like a memorial service.
我在年轻的时候，我根本不敢邀请我的朋友到教会。
So when I was young, I just didn't want to invite my friend to church.
我的教会人很少，所以我们找不到人可以服侍。
Because there's nobody who wants to serve.
所以我爸爸找那个 worship leader 领唱的人呢，你知道他的资格是什么吗？
So you know how my dad found a worship leader?
就是爱主。
Just love Jesus.
你们好像有点听不懂哈，就是领唱不是挑他会不会唱，而是爱主的这个词。
So we're not picking based on skill set, whether the person can sing, just as long as the person loves God.
所以教会又没有人，所以我就要逼去弹钢琴。
And so I was forced to play the keyboard.
我在那边越弹，我就心里想，他如果这首歌唱完，有人会感动，教会一定有鬼。
I thought after that song, if somebody get touched, it's not the Holy Spirit, it's another spirit in this place.
你知道那些爱主的人常常属灵兮兮的。
And you know the spiritual people, they're a little bit flaky sometimes.
他已经唱成这样子了，他还转过头来跟我们这些司琴说，可不可以给我一个恩高的音色？
And he's singing, he turns to me, can you give me something with a little bit more anointing?
我想说你唱成这样子。
And I thought you're singing like this.
我们的会友是犯了什么罪要坐在这里听你唱。
What kind of sin did our people commit that they have to listen to this?
怎么可能会有恩膏呢？
There's no anointing in this place.
你知道有的时候很夸张，我们聚完会他很生气。
And so after the meeting, he's very mad.
所以他就转过来跟我们这些敬拜团员召聚起来。
And also he turned to us and he gathered us together from the worship team.
所以今天我们没有感受到恩膏，每个人把眼睛闭起来。这个礼拜是谁犯罪得罪了神，请举手。
He says I didn't feel any anointing, so just raise your hand if you sin against God. So we're gonna come to the, you know, get to the bottom of this.
我当然眼睛都闭起来，但是我心里想说，就是你的声音得罪了神。
And I thought to myself, it's your voice that sinned against the Lord.
那个年代呢，台湾的敬拜赞美受到韩国影响。
And at that time, our prison worship in town was heavily influenced by Korea.
韩国的牧师呢，把敬拜赞美这些很好的诗歌带来台湾。
And so they brought a lot of their praise songs here to Taiwan.
所以当我们台湾的教会都还是很传统的时候呢，他带来一些比较新一点的敬拜方式。
And so they would bring these worship songs from overseas here to Taiwan.
可是你知道韩国也是有点问题。
But you know, there's also something wrong with.Koreans.
糟糕，这个直播真的很，我都不能尽情的讲我想讲的。我很爱韩国人。
没关系，以上的论言跟我们教会无关。记得他是台北复兴堂的主任牧师。
好，那我们回到圣经的话。你知道韩国人讲话就是那个腔调有点悲情的感觉。
When Koreans speak, it's like they're always in a Korean drama. You know,
你看那个，对，你看他们很浪漫的在西餐厅吃晚餐的讲话对话。
Even if they're sitting at the romantic dinner, the way they talk.
明明很甜蜜的。
It's supposed to be sweet.
应该很高兴的。
It's supposed to be happy.
可是韩剧讲话就是请你们都请两个，请康请康。
But this is how they speak in Korean.Dramas.
所以你知道那个韩国牧师来带我们敬拜的时候，就是刚刚那种语调。
And so when he would lead worship, this is the tone of voice that he would use.
所以那个年代所有的教会每一个人都学他带敬拜的方式。
And so everybody learned from him and led worship like him.
前一首歌呢，大家还开心的唱赞美的快歌。
And so the previous song, people are happy, they're dancing.
一转到慢歌，好像变了一个人。
And once you get to a slow song, it's like a totally different person.
所以每个教会都变成叫做主啊，我们感谢你。
Everyone's like, Jesus, we praise.
然后我在台下想说，到底在哭什么
？And I'm sitting there thinking, what are we crying about?
教会，神的百姓应该是一群最喜乐的人聚集的地方。
But the house of God is supposed to be a joyful place.
哎，如果你相信，大声的拍手吧，荣耀归给主耶稣。
If you believe that, give God some praise.
哎，你们教会蛮好的，拍都拍一两分钟，我只要讲二十分钟的道就。
欢迎常来，欢迎常来。但是以上的论点跟我们教会无关。
哎呦，直播我真不能讲。
没关系，等一下我们吃饭的时候再讲。
好好 ，OK OK。所以你知道神的话语成就的那一天，你刚刚看到经文，那个 撒拉亚伯拉罕给他的孩子取名叫以撒。
See the moment when this promise came to pass, he named his son Isaac, meaning laughing and joy.
哎，是很热的感觉是？笑到很热，你们的冷气真的要加强一点。
好，我们会加油。
好，第五节第六节，来第五节第六节 ，Peter 帮我念。
All right, so let's keep reading. And Abraham was 100 years old when his son Isaac was born unto him. And Sarah said, "God hath King James hath made me to laugh, so that all that hear will laugh with me."
所以那一天，他们巴不得所有人都跟他一起欢喜快乐。
And so that day, they wanted everybody to laugh with them.
亚伯拉罕又是当时候首富，他就把其他村庄的好朋友都叫来。
So Abraham, he was a rich man, so he gathered all these people from the different villages to come together.
第八节说
verse 8.It says, and the child grew, and it was weaned, and Abraham made a great feast the same day that Isaac was weaned.
你知道那一天他们就开了一个 party.
That day they had a party.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，如果你在教会当中感觉到神祝福的喜乐，你一定要邀请朋友来听。
Now, if you feel the blessing and the presence of God at church, you have to invite your friends.
要让所有的人跟你一同享受在主里的欢喜。
So they can also enjoy this joy of the Lord.
给旁边一个 high five， 说下个礼拜你要带朋友来。
Give somebody high five. Time to bring a friend next week.
所以你知道吗？就在孩子断奶的时候，那个时候要断奶，大概三岁左右。
And so at that time, you get weaned when you're about 3 years old.
啊，所以他就办了一个非常盛大的 party.
He had this big party.
全村的人都来，有美酒，有音乐，大家都开心的不得了。
And everybody came, and everybody was partying.
但是就在那个欢喜快乐的现场，有一个不为人知的惊天动地的家庭战争正要开始。
But at that time of celebration, some family drama was brewing in the background.
第九节。
So number nine, verse nine. And Sarah saw the son of Hagar the Egyptian, which she had born unto Abraham, mocking.
这个背景。长话短说，就是神应许了亚伯拉罕要给他一个孩子。
See, God has promised Abraham that He would bring him a son.
但是他的太太撒拉一直生不出孩子。
But his wife Sarah couldn't give birth.
所以他等不及，就找了他太太的婢女，也就是女仆人，就生了一个孩子叫做以实玛利。
And so he couldn't wait, so he found his wife's servant girl, and with her they had a son called Ishmael.
所以你可以想象那个画面吗
？So can you imagine this?
那天在一个就像这样的夜店的 party 当中
，You're having a party in a place like this.
所有人都欢庆，撒拉生了一个以撒。
Everybody's happy. Isaac was being born.
但是有一个人不开心，就是那个女主角。
But there was somebody who wasn't happy.
因为她玩得开心，大家敬酒的时候，她余光会瞄到夏甲生的儿子以实玛利。
Because even though he's having a great time, he would look at the son, Ishmael.
所以你知道亚伯拉罕在敬酒的时候，眼角都在注意他太太开不开心。
So Isaac, you know, even though he's drinking, his eyes is looking at his wife.
因为只有开心的太太才会有幸福美满的男人。
Because a happy wife equal a happy life.
所以哦，他大家都在开心，没有人知道亚伯拉罕跟撒拉其实里面呢波涛汹涌。
And everybody was having a great time, but they didn't know what was happening between Abraham and his wife.
所以你看下一节经文。
And so next verse, it says, "Wherefore she said unto Abraham, Cast out this bondwoman and her son, for the son of this bondwoman shall not be an heir with my son, even with Isaac."
你读圣经一定要有画面。
Now when you read the Bible, you need to have this mental picture.
所以请跟我一起回到当时候的光景。
So let's come back into the story with a mental picture.
那个时候是一个大家狂欢的时候，所以会放这样的音乐。
Imagine this party with this music.
来听一下。
Oh, this is music.Wait, I think we.
教会还是有问题的啦，不是这么完美的。
Is there music? Oh, okay.
好好，先停一下，好。
Okay,
停一下、哦、
let's pause the music. Thank you.
等一下，我们就这样子。等一下，我说 party 的时候，请问要做一点 party 的噪音出来。
Okay, so when we play the music with the party, you gotta act like you're in a nightclub. Just pretend you're in a nightclub.
不用 act，、okay? 就活出你们自己就可以
了。活出你们自己就行了。
所以等一下我们音乐一下了，你就有一个 party 的声音，让你感受一下那天在亚伯拉罕家发生什么事。
And so just imagine with me what's happening at that party, all right?
一直开心到我抓了手收起来为止。
So this party, let's have fun, let's laugh, let's talk until the music stops.
来 party!
Party! Y tíramelo, mami chula. No games, you see. You can put the blame on me. All right, stop.
我感觉只有前排的人好像比较真实活出自己。
There's only the only people sitting in front are being themselves.
后面感觉都是读书人的感觉。
所有属灵的人都在后面。
可以再一次吗？我们感受一下亚伯拉罕他家的。
Again, let's enjoy this party.
Party.
This party. I ain't trying to keep it real. I'm
trying to keep wealth and that's for real. 好，请坐，可以了，可以，可以了。
Please be seated.
这时候。这个经文呢，就是出现在下个音乐要出现了。
And this verse is coming out at the next this music that's coming up. Listen to this music.
你们这些人是会看明视的吗？
Oh, maybe Netflix, but.
你知道当时候这个音乐一下的时候，明视的那个男女主角都用台湾国语讲话。
知道 ，in moments like this, people would speak in Taiwanese, like on the TV.
亚伯拉罕
，Yeah, Abraham.
我跟你讲
，Let me tell you.
你把这个俗女给我赶出去
，Send this girl away.
不然我们就来验 DNA.
Once we're gonna test the DNA.
我跟你讲，现在做牧师很累。
It's hard being a pastor. You have to come up with all these things.
你可以想象吗？在那个很开心的场合里面。
So imagine at a time like this, in a party like this.
其实还是有一些秘密在心中。
And there's still things going on the inside.
十一节告诉我们说
，Verse 11 says this.
他为这个孩子的问题很忧愁。
And the thing was very grievous in Abram's sight.Because of his son,
你可以想象像我们这样子欢庆的场合，其实很多人心中仍然有一些秘密。
Can you imagine even in a place like this where we're all laughing and having a great time, there's still secrets on the inside?
我们可以手中拿着酒杯跟人家敬酒欢庆，谢谢大家来看我孩子啊满月这样的气氛。
You can be welcoming all your guests, welcoming them, saying thank you for coming to the party, and yet something is happening in your heart.
但是男主人跟女主人心中没有平静。
There is no peace within them.
为了他生命。之前所犯的问题，生命的那些难关，那些困难，常常很忧愁。
Because of a mistake that he made in the past, he's grieving on the inside.
这正是很多我们在教会里面，甚至基督徒的光景。
This is what we face a lot of time in church, even in the lives of Christians.
亲爱的朋友，弟兄姐妹，我要告诉你，亚伯拉罕是圣经里面说到他是信心的伟人。
You know, the Bible says that Abraham, he's a man of faith.
你以为信心的伟人好像每一天让你看见的都是无忧无虑没有问题吗
But a man of faith doesn't mean he's living every day like there's no problem, there's no
trouble. 但真正在信心的伟人里面他还是仍然要面对他生命的软弱
Even a man of faith had to face these weaknesses in his life.
今天我想要透过这个信息帮助所有在这里的弟兄姐妹可以重新找到在主里的喜乐。
And so I want to help you to find your joy in God again.
等一下我们祷告主把那个在你里面他本来放下的信心重新的点燃起来。
And so we're going to pray that God will reignite this faith that's inside.
你要相信一件事，亚伯拉罕都面对这样的问题，我们没有一个人可以告诉别人我们好像义人，我们不会问题，我们都是很好的。
And so even if Abraham had to face this, we also have to face this.
今天我们想要来看亚伯拉罕到底他心中隐藏了哪些秘密。
So we're going to look at what was happening inside Abraham's heart.
第一个就是罪的问题。
Number one, sin.
他的问题里面呢，其实不是说啊，好像这一夕间就才产生的。
See, his problem didn't just occur overnight.
他年轻的时候，人家想要觊觎他的太太，他骗人家说那是他的妹妹。
When he was much younger, somebody wanted his wife, so he lied and said that's just my sister.
有很多在有信心的人心中，他仍然要面对就是不为人知罪的问题。
See, even with people of faith, we still have to face that issue of sin in our lives.
亚伯拉罕是当时候的首富，很有钱，很有势力。
Abraham was rich, he was famous.
神亲自的跟他面对面说话。
God spoke to him face to face.
仍然要面对生命当中被罪捆绑的光景。
And yet he still has to face this issue of sin in his life.
提摩太后书告诉我们说，人若自洁脱离卑贱的事，才能做贵重的器皿。
Second Timothy chapter 2:21 says, if a man therefore purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified.
今天早上在这个聚会当中，不要把自己罪的问题好像当作视若无睹。
And so don't overlook. the issue of sin in your life.
神渴望想要祝福你的生命，活出有信心、有意义的人生。
God wants to bless your life. God wants your life to be filled with meaning.
但仇敌每一天都想要用罪把我们框在一个小房间里面，走不出来。
But every single day, the enemy wants to trap you in your cycle of sin.
连亚伯拉罕这样的信心的英雄，他都要面对。今天早晨，我们都要得释放。
Even Abraham had to face this. We also need to be set free.
第二个问题
Now, the second problem was
this,
was that he had a lack of faith.
你说不可能啊，他是信心之父。
He said, what? I thought he's called the father of faith.
我们刚刚提到，他不只有罪的问题，其实他还等不及上帝给他祝福。
Well, he couldn't wait until the promises of God come to pass.
所以十一节，我们刚刚的圣经才会说，他为儿子的缘故很忧愁。
So this is why it says that he was very grievous because of his son.
弟兄姐妹，你知道忧愁的背后，是因为我们放不下一些事。
You grieve because you can't let go of certain things.
有些父母亲呢，很担心孩子很多东西。
You know, some parents they're so worried about their kids.
我们在台湾有一种说法，就是有一种冷叫做妈妈觉得冷。
There's a kind of, anyways, it makes perfect sense in Chinese.
常常担心孩子有没有穿得暖，读书有没有好的学历。
You know, parents are always worried about everything. Are you dressed well? Do you have a good education?
每天都在担心。
Every day you're worrying.
担心安全，担心未来，担心有没有好的发展。
You're worrying about the future. You're worrying about what's happening next.
我们为了孩子的缘故很忧愁。
And so for our kids, for our children, we grieve.
同样的，我们为了我们的一些感情，我们也很忧愁。
And we also grieve because of our relationships.
我们到底要不要跟这样的人交往？要不要走下去？要不要有未来
？Do I have a future with this person? Should we keep going?
我们会忧愁，是因为我们对上帝没有信心。
We grieve because we have a lack of faith.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，你要知道，上帝会为你预备最好、最合适的。
But God prepares the best for us.
你不要担忧，不要为这些东西忧虑，你只要信靠神。
Don't worry about these things. Trust in the Lord.
听好，连信心之父都有信心软弱的问题。
But even a father of faith has moments of weakness.
今天早晨，你需要做的事情就是向神敞开真实的自己。
What do you need to do? Be honest.
我们需要来到神面前说，是神啊，我真的放不开。
And say, yes, God, it's hard for me to let go.
我的研究所是念諮商跟輔導。
When I was, graduate study, I studied counseling.
我们我那个时候要毕业，要做300个小时的个案才可以毕业。
And so to graduate, I need 300 hours of in the field.
所以我写论文的时候，我每天都待在这个諮商室里面，面对这些个案。
And so for all those hours, I'm facing these people, talking to them.
后来为了要找个案，我打电话给一个很后段的这个高中说我想要去当你们的辅导老师，为了个案。
And then because I needed to complete this thing, so I called a school and said, "Can I come and be a counselor?"
那些进来的这些高中的孩子呢，你都可以发现长袖底下呢，他有割伤自己的这些伤口。
And a lot of these high school kids, they have cuts on their wrists when they come in.
慢慢谈，慢慢谈，才知道他一直很想分开一段感情，但是分不开。
And as I chat with them, I realized some of them want to break up from a relationship, but they couldn't.
我问他说：“你为什么不跟他分手？”
I said, "Why don't you just break up?"
因为他就跟我讲说：“如果我现在跟他分手，明天就会有别的女生跟他在一起。”
And this girl was said, "If I break up with him tomorrow, he's going to get some other girl."
我虽然是諮商师，但是我不知道要怎么样跟他形容我心中的担忧跟忧虑。
Even as a counselor, I didn't know how to share with her.
有很多的时候，当我们陷入在这些放不掉的感情或信心的问题，我们是很难被说服的。
Because when you just can't let go, it's hard to persuade you of anything
else. 我们总觉得你不懂我，你不知道我在什么样的光景。
Because you just feel nobody understands me. You don't know what's happening.
你不知道我失去这个工作，失去这个男朋友或女朋友，我会面临到什么样的压力。
You don't know if I lose this girlfriend, lose this boyfriend, what's going to happen to me?
但亲爱的朋友，对我来讲，我确实不知道你的状况。
And yes, you're right. I don't understand.
但我知道，我有一位上帝是信心创始又成终的上帝。
I have a God who is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
他会为爱他的人所预备，是眼睛没看过，耳朵没听过，心里也没想过的事。
He has prepared for those who loving are things that we can't even begin to imagine.
哎，想拍手，我们就热烈的拍掌，把荣耀归给上帝，好吧
？Give a clap to Jesus.
除了罪的问题、信心的问题，今天我第三个跟大家谈到就是他不顺服的问题。
And now this third problem that he had was a lack of obedience.
一个与神可以面对面谈话、像朋友的人，他仍然要面对上帝话语，你要不要照着做
？Even though Abraham could talk to God face to face, he still has the dilemma of whether
he shall obey what God said.
这所有在 party 里面产生出这个纠结在他心中跟太太中间的问题，就是因为他等不及要这个以撒的出生，就先跟夏甲生出了以实玛利。
And all these problems was traced back to the fact that he couldn't wait for the promise of God to come to pass. So he did this thing with and gave birth to Ishmael.
明明从撒拉所生的才算是他的后裔。
Because God spoke to him and said, "It's from your wife Sarah. That's the son that's going to be your inheritance."
他清楚知道，但是他没有做。
He understood in his heart, but he didn't do it.
而且你知道，我们当我们不想顺服神的时候，我们有很多的理由可以讲解我们好像是对的。
You know, when you don't want to obey God, you can come up with all kinds of excuses why you can't obey God.
我们还会因为要说服自己，减低我们的那些罪恶感，我们还觉得说，嗯，一定要听牧师的吗？一定要听小组长的吗
？And we might even say to ourselves, "Do I really have to listen?"
小组长讲的，牧师讲的，真的是对的吗
？Is really what he's saying, the pastor, the small group?
难道没有别的路？嗯
，Is there not any other alternatives?
我们为了不想顺服神，你知道人性里面多黑暗到一个地步，我们还照着自己的方法去解释圣经。
And we will even use our own interpretation to explain what the Bible says.
最根源的问题就是我们中了这个说谎人之父撒旦的诡计。
Because we have fallen into the trap from the father of lies.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我们为什么忧愁？其实这一生当中最过的最平安喜乐的道路就是顺服神的道路。
Now why do we grieve? It's because we're not obeying God. When we obey Him, our lives are blessed.
我们会到现在十五年，有很多的人会问我们说：“难道圣经讲，那我们先住在一起，然后我们那如果以后不顺呢？牧师你要负责吗？”
And you know, we would say, "You know, we just want to cohabit a little bit, see how it turns out." No, if we don't cohabit, how will we know if we're compatible? Are you going to be one responsible?
我想要当着大家面承认一件事，就是我你的未来会不会幸福，我确实不知道。
Now I cannot guarantee your future whether it's going to be blessed or not.
但听好，我知道一件事。
But I do know one thing.
雅各书说
，James says this.
故此你要顺服神，抵挡魔鬼，魔鬼才会逃跑。
Submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil, he will flee from you.
拍手把荣耀归给主，好不好
？Come, let's give glory to God.
我不知道你的未来会怎么样，但我知道顺服神，魔鬼才会逃跑。
I don't know what your future will be, but I do know only when you resist the devil will he run away from you.
如果你有聪明智慧，不要拿来挑战神，好好拿来顺服神的话语。
If you are smart, use your smartness to obey God, not to resist.
这一条路总比你每一天在那边想。想那些歪道理，然后说服自己，然后找出一些东西，然后最主要就是要减低你的罪恶感。那为什么不好好拿来单纯的顺服神的话
？That's a better use of your brain power. Use it to obey God rather than coming up all these excuses as to why you can't.
以赛亚书明明告诉我们，神的意念高过我们的意念，神的道路高过我们的道路。
Isaiah says that God's thoughts are higher than our thoughts. His ways are higher than our ways.
接下来这个 PPT 我觉得很重要。我们读圣经其实是在跟新我们的想法，不是在满足你的私欲的。因为你阅读圣经，你的价值观被改变，你的思想改变，才会找到将来没有想过的路去解决问题。
It says when we read the Bible, it actually renews our mind. When our values and perception are changed, we'll find the solutions which we have never thought of before.
请你不要把你的聪明智慧拿来找圣经的话去佐证你的错误行为，请你把你的时间花在好好读神的话，求主来更多改变。
Don't spend your time to use the Word of God to excuse your sins. Use it to transform your mind.
因为人心怎么思量，他的为人就怎么样。
Because as the man think, so is he.
你的思想改变了，你就会有从神而来的生活模式。
As your mind is renewed, your life is changed.
最近我读到一个文章呢，那个文章呢，证明了哥罗西书的第三章的经文。
You know, recently I read this article and the proof what Colossians chapter 3 said.
Peter, 帮我们读好不好
？It says, "If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above."Which Christ sit on the right hand of God, set your affection on things above, not on things of the earth.
你知道什么叫做思念上面的事呢？就是天国的价值观。
You know what does it mean to think of the things above? It's to think about kingdom values.
什么叫做思念下面的事呢？就是世俗的价值观。
And on the things of earth, it's talking about secular values.
你知道我年轻的时候有个同学这样讲。
You know, I had a friend who told me this.
他喜欢上两个女生，他在做抉择。
And he loved two different girls, and he's trying to decide which one to.
有一天他已经烦恼很久，有一天他很高兴的来找我说他读到圣经有了答案。
And it's been troubling him for a long time, so one day he came to me and said, I read the Bible, I got my answer.
就是这节经文害了他，因为他那一个女生住十二楼，一个住三楼。
He says, one of the girls lives on top, one of the girls lives on the bottom.
神告诉他要思念上面的事。
And he says, God is saying, think of the one things above.
我们很糟糕的就是我们用自己的理解方式去曲解神的话语。
See, we use our own stupidity to understand the Bible.
所以你知道我读到那个文章说，现在世界的教育体系什么都可以教，但是太少教属天的价值观。
See, the education in the world today, it teaches everything but the values of the kingdom.
我们教数学，但是我们没有教对的动机。
We teach mathematics but not the right motives.
我们教历史，没有教谦卑。
We teach history.But not humanity.
我们教地理，我们没有教真实的慷慨。
We teach geography, but not generosity.
我们教科学，可是我们没有教用爱去服侍其他人。
We teach science, but not serving.
我们教几何，但是我们没有教从神来真实的喜乐。
We teach geometry, but not joy.
我们带给大家很多商业，很多经济，但是我们没有教从神而来的信心。
We teach commerce, but not confidence.
听好。我们需要属天的价值观。
We need a kingdom value.
顺服神，仇敌才会逃跑。
Only when you obey God will the enemy flee.
来，我们拍手把荣耀归给主，好不好？
Come and give God glory.
今天我们来到最后一个重点。
We're coming to our last point.
亚伯拉罕他生命当中有罪的问题，有不顺服的问题。
He had a problem with a sin, a problem with not obeying.
但最后一个问题，他还是要面对，就是跟家人的关系。
And the last one he had was family relationships.
我们在一个闹哄哄的 party， 或者在成功的人生，我们终究还是要面对跟家人的关系。
No matter what kind of party you have, no matter what kind of friendship, you still have to face your family problems.
有很多人在光鲜亮丽的外表底下，其实已经很久没有跟家人好好讲话。
A lot of us, we might look like we're having a great time on the outside, but you haven't talked to your family in a long time.
仇敌很想要我们有一个破碎的人生。
The enemy wants you to have a broken life.
他想说你反正有金钱了，有一些不错的工作了，你大概就满足了。
He says, you have all these things, a great job, you should be satisfied.
但你知道一个事实吗？就是耶和华如果要救你，他一定会救你到底。
But listen, if God wants to save you, he will save you to the end.
他不会单纯的只想要给你好的工作、好的职业，他要你全人都健康起来。
He doesn't just want to give you a great job, he wants all your whole being to prosper.
来到上帝的面前，有一个很美好的祝福，就是一个家一个家都要被神拯救。
And so when you come before God, families upon families shall be saved.
我读这段经文里面呢，最后这两节经文我非常的感动。
And so when I read this, it really spoke to me.
来 ，Peter 帮我们。
It says in verse 12, and God said unto Abraham, Let it not be grievous in your sight, because of the lad.
是不是我们用这个？
我们用 King James， it's 最后一次会讲这句话的，已经四百年前就已经过世了。
所以现在比较是 NIV， right？
Yeah， but it's okay. Okay. It's okay. NIV means never incorrect. That's why we use it. And because of thy bond woman and all thy Sarah hath said unto thee.
好，没关系，你念完了就好了。可以，可以，可以，我们懂就好了。
You understand？
不要浪费我时间，我剩下。我觉得最感动就这两节经文。
See, it's these two verses.
神说的是什么呢？
What did God say?
听好，我要结束了。
Listen.
神说，孩子，不管你搞砸什么，我会负责任。
God says, no matter how bad you screw up, I will be the one responsible. I will clean up.
就算是夏甲所生，我来让他成为一国。
Yeah, even though this Ishmael, I will still make him into a great nation.
就算是你因为罪的问题、不顺服的问题、失去信心的问题，搞砸了你的人生一切。
Even though you mess up because of your lack of faith, your lack of obedience, I will still take responsibility.
神对亚伯拉罕说，
And God
没关系，我为你负责。
God says, I will pay the price. I will take responsibility.
今天中午在这里。
So this afternoon here in this place.
我感觉神也在对你说话。
God is also speaking to you.
我们在一个非常喜乐的教会，非常美好的人生当中，仍然要面对内心的这些挣扎。
Even at a place like this, the place that's filled with joy, we still have to face these issues, don't we?
可能连坐在你旁边或是很亲近的人都不知道你有罪的问题、不顺服的问题、信心软弱的问题。
Even maybe the people next to you, they don't know that you're facing these issues in your life.
甚至很亲近的朋友不知道你已经好久没有跟家人好好的谈话。
Maybe even your closest friend doesn't know that you have these family issues and you haven't talked to your family in a while.
甚至我们看到很多我们觉得很模范夫妻的，其实他们私底下不像我们想象的。
And maybe even some couples who you admire, maybe you know they're not who they make up themselves to be.
但今天早上没关系，连信心之父都面对到生命的问题。
But please listen, even Abraham, the father of faith, has to face these issues.
只要你愿意来到神的面前，把你的心向上帝敞开。
As long as you're willing to come before the Lord and open up your hearts.
只要你不要再每次戴着面具到了教会，把面具装上去，然后敬拜完又离开。
As long as you're not putting on a mask every time you come before God and worship.
你知道很吊诡，我不知道英文怎么讲，就是很吊诡的一件事，就是我们都是承认自己是罪人才相信耶稣的。
You know what's interesting is that every single one we have to admit that we're sinners before we can accept Christ.
但当我们成为主的儿女之后，我们一辈子都在隐藏我们是罪人的这件事情。
But after we became a Christian, we're hiding those sins for the rest of our life.
我们都做过这个祷告，说主啊，求你赦免我的罪，接纳我，我打开我的心，接受你成为我的救主。
We all have prayed and said, God, I open up my heart. Would you come in and be my Lord and Savior?
但居然我们跨过这个界限，成为主的儿女之后。我们在隐藏我们到底为了什么？
But after we became a Christian, after we became a son and daughter of God, we still hiding these things.
亲爱的朋友，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，来到神的面前，最棒的一件事就是我们可以敞开自己。
Friends, the best thing is that when we come before God, we can be true.
让他知道说，主啊，就算这么开心的人生当中，我仍然有我生命的软弱。
You can say, even at a place like this, I still have weaknesses inside.
甚至有可能有别人很羡慕我的人生，但是主，我向你坦诚，我需要你。
My life might be an envy to others, but I admit I still need you.
我知道我搞砸了一些东西，但是我知道你会愿意为我负责任。
I've messed things up, but I'm thankful that you're willing to pay the price for that.
我知道在我做罪人的时候，你就为我死，基督的爱就在此显明。
That even when I was a sinner, you died for me.
亲爱的朋友，你已经来到一个台北最好的教会。
Friends, you have come to the best church.
但是如果你没有把你的心门打开，让耶稣可以看见你真实的需要。
But if you have not opened up your heart.
这样的聚会在一百次、在一千次，对你的人生都没有帮助。
Even you can come here 100 times, 1,000, it's not going to do anything.
今天中午好不好让我鼓励你
？So this afternoon,
来到上帝的面前，把你的心真实的敞开。
Come before God, open up your heart.
说这个不是一个普通的聚会，这是我与你面对面的聚会。
This is not just any other meeting. It's a time for
me to open up your heart.
Jesus, I need you.
如果是这样子，拍手把荣耀归给主耶稣。
Come on, if that is you, give glory to God.
好不好？我邀请你从位置上站起来。
Stand up.
敬拜团带我们唱这个诗歌，我要带你们祷告。
As the worship team lead us into this song, we're gonna pray together.
I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation, and I will put my.Show me who you are.
不好，我可以邀请每一个人把眼睛闭起来，头低下来。
Why don't we close our eyes, bow our heads?
今天中午我不会让你难为情，要你走出来。
Today I'm not going to ask you to come to the front.
但我需要你做一个决定，就是向主耶稣敞开你的生命。
But today I want to ask you to open your heart.
不管你坐在哪里，楼上楼下任何一个地方。
No matter where you are sitting in at the first floor or the second level.
我邀请你对主有个呐喊，就是主耶稣，我需要你。
But today I want you to cry out to Jesus and say, Jesus, I need you.
没有人知道我生命的问题，但是你完全知道。
Even if nobody knows what's going on in my heart, you do, Lord.
甚至没有任何人可以解决我的问题，但是你愿意为我负责。
And I know nobody can fix this, but I know you are the one who's going to take the responsibility.
我知道你不只救过去的我，现在我，你还会救。
You're not just saving me right now or from my past, but you're
你要救我，你会救我到底。
You're going to send me to the very end.
你不只是给我财务的丰盛，不只是给我身体的健康，你要救给我一个全新的我。
You want to give, you not just want to bless me financially my past, but you want to give me a new me.
所以眼睛闭着，头低着，没有人看别人的时候。
So nobody's looking around.
我要问你，有在我们当中有哪一个人？你说主耶稣，我要向你打开我的全心。
How many of you said Jesus, I open up my heart to you?
求你来帮助我，求你来救我。
Help me, save me, rescue me.
甚至亚伯拉罕一个信心之父都有的问题，神也求你来帮助我。
And even Abraham, the father of faith, struggled with these things. I need you.
今天中午是我遇见你的中午。
This is an afternoon where I will meet you.
是我不再隐藏自己的中午。
I'm not going to hide myself.
是我向你真实说我需要你的中午。
I'm going to be honest before you.
如果这也是你的祷告，等一下当我数到三，我邀请你高高的把手举起来。
If that is you want to put, ask you to put up your hand on.
不用看任何人，我们就是来寻求
主。Don't look at anybody else.
所以等一下我数到三，你如果是你，不管你站在哪里，就高高举手，我们来祷告。
So as I kind of think, I want to ask you to put up your hand. We're going
to pray. 牧师要为你祷告。
I want to pray with you.
让主耶稣的恩惠帮助可以临到我们。
So that the power of God, the grace of God.
准备好了吗？一、二、三。One, two, three.高高举起手来，高高举起手来，开口祷告，开口祷告。现在每一个人向主来祷告，说主，我站在这里，我在这里，我在这里，我需要你，我需要你。每一个人开口来说主啊，我打开我的心，我需要你。求你帮助我，求你救我，求你给我力量，求你把信心加给我。今天中午让我遇见你。
Help me to see you, meet you.
我知道我搞砸了我的人生的一个部分。
I know I've screwed up in the past.
今天只有你可以帮助我。
But today only you can rescue me.
创造生命的救主。
Be the Lord and Savior of my life.
恢复我的人生。
Rescue me.
恢复我与人的关系。恢复我的工作和职场。
Rescue me, restore me.
恢复我的婚姻与感情。
Restore my marriage, restore my relationships.
给我智慧，让我走回正路。
Give me wisdom to come back to you.
今天中午我要重新的顺服你。
Today I will obey you once again.
帮助我的人生。
Help me, God.
因为遇见你可以完全不一样。
Because when I see you face to face, meet you face to face, it will change my life.
谢谢耶稣听我们的祷告。
Thank you, Jesus, for listening to my prayer.
奉耶稣的名。
Jesus, and we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
拍手把荣耀归给主。
Let's give glory to God.
收看，我希望你有得到非常多的收获。我邀请你一起来订阅我们的频道，并且分享这个影片在你的社群媒体上面给你的朋友。也许你的朋友真的很需要这样子的一个祝福。那我也鼓励你一起来报名服事团队，一起加入我们，一起来建造这个家。我们下个礼拜见哦。